If you notice, when you look at the insert, it's two paragraphs. In the first, I'll call them unit one and unit two. In the first unit, it's a question and answer session between a lawyer and Jeeves. So the lawyer's question is, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Well, Jesus being Jesus answers a question with a question. What is written in the law? And he answers him, the Lord does, love God and neighbor as yourselves. And Jesus replies, do this and you will live. In other words, do what you know is right. But that isn't enough for the lawyer, because lawyers want to get legalized. So he wants to now have Jesus define who is my neighbor. And instead of defining it for him, Jesus tells him a story about neighborly behavior. That's one of the things Jesus does. He invites us to understand. He doesn't give us rules and regulations. You do this, you don't do this, you do this, you don't do this. He wants to engage us in a process of tussling with Scripture. So he tells us the story about the priest and the Levite who walked by a man who'd been wronged. Now, for those of you who don't know, a Samaritan in ancient Israel would be anyone who is not Jewish, okay? And anyone who is not Jewish was a sinner. So the person that stepped up to the plate here and took care of this man who had been robbed, in Jewish culture, would have been seen as a sinner. Samaritan is kind of a dirty word. For our lives now. Do we have to be holy? Do we have to do everything that's right? Do we have to be perfect? Or are we all sinners who need to do our best and to help our neighbors? Because Jesus doesn't define neighbor as a legal term. According to Jesus, neighbor is a fluid term. Who is your neighbor? There's a wonderful prayer. It was initially by St. Augustine. And I say it quite frequently. I take the liberty of saying, okay, God, when I say this, I want you to make it matter. I want to go forward until the next time you remind me to say it again. Christ, and think about this. And when I do it, I actually think about it. Christ within me. Christ above me. Christ below me. Christ to my right and Christ to my left. Christ all around me. To guide and direct me that each meeting, each task undertaken by, with, and in Christ, according to your glory. If I say it in church, I'm thinking about the people in the church, but think about all the neighborhoods out here. Think about the neighborhoods back here. God is asking us to think about our neighbors. Has anybody seen the program What Would You Do? How many have seen that program? Not too many. It's been a while, it hasn't been on. I remember seeing an episode where they have a coach. What they do is set up scenarios that are kind of disturbing and see what people actually do and then ask them about it afterwards. See who pays attention and see who doesn't. And I remember an episode where a coach was abusing an athlete. say something? Hot day like this? But he wouldn't let an athlete, okay, it was an actor, kept saying, can I have some water? I need some water. I need some water. And the coach wouldn't let him have water. Would you say something? Or would you let the coach continue this behavior? How about if you're in a store and the cashier has to pick something out of the bag, maybe a lottery ticket, and you see someone stealing from the register? Would you say something? Would you do something? How about parents who are shaming a child for stealing and lying? And I'm not saying, no, you shouldn't have done that, but saying, oh, you're a bad kid, you're no good, you're gonna end up in jail, you're gonna do this, you're gonna do that. Think about what you could hear if that was happening. Think about what you might have said. And you're witnessing this. What would you do? In the program, there was generally a gender difference in reactions. Mothers would come forward more than fathers. And there was a racial difference. African Americans and people of color would come forward more than Euro-American people who know our place. So who is our neighbor? We're talking about it a lot in this church. We know it's community. Who is our neighbor in worship? We have all these people of Wayland who has just been baptized. It's family and friends. Some of them we know, and some of them we don't know. Are they our neighbors? How about those who live outside our community? How about those who are vulnerable? Our children and our youth. We've talked recently about trying to figure out how to do some lunches for children who might not have good lunches over the summer vacation. How about the sick, the lonely, the unemployed, and the underemployed? How about our elders who may not have air conditioning in the seat? Are we checking on them? How about the homeless and the hungry? We live here in this community in neighborhoods. But what if your neighbor, remember, the definition is fluid. What if your neighbor was an it? Meaning the earth that we care for, meaning the water that we want to be clean. We don't knock more nearly as much as going down with Hurricane Barry. But water is essential to children for healthy brain cell development. What if they don't have that? Think about Flint, Michigan, and all those children who now have lead poisoning because it was lead. We need water for our crops and our trees and flowers across our land. We need water so that the plants grow and the insects can pollinate them. Clean water is vital. Now I'm going to make a pun. And I guess it is intended. I put in my notes there was no pun intended. When I wrote it, I hadn't thought of it, but it is going to be intended now. Defining neighbor is fluid, whether it's family, friends, neighbors, or more. We need to be taking care of our people and our planet. That's what Jesus is talking about. We need to take care of those around us. We need to stand up for those who are oppressed, who are homeless, who need our help. And when you're getting that little, I really don't like the way that mom's hitting her kid in the shopping center. And you want to say something, get over yourself and say something. We have this New England mentality here. We can't get into other people's business. Sometimes because it's a privacy area. Sometimes we're afraid. What if they have a knife? So think about it. Think about who your neighbor is and then ask.